Dr. Murphy, professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Morning.
Well, this drug is exciting news. As you know, some people hear emergency use and it makes them nervous. What can you tell us about all this?
Well, this drug and two others, similar drugs that are also in development by Atea Pharmaceuticals and Roche, their partner, and Pfizer. Everyone knows Pfizer because of the vaccine, but they also make pills. This is a fantastic news because this is a very short course of treatment, just 5 days of treatment, and you cut the hospitalization rate in half. And in the study that they just reported yesterday in 775 patients, there were no deaths in the treatment group and 8 deaths in the placebo group. So it has a huge effect. As far as safety goes, they didn't even report any side effects yet.
Let's talk about the daily positivity rate and the number of daily cases. They are down, way down, 2% positivity. We were up at 7% back in the spring, I believe. But deaths are still high, just as high as February. So I think people are confused where we are with the pandemic.
Yeah, you have to just think of the treatment, the disease course of COVID. So first you get infected. A week later you get symptoms. A week after that, or in 2 weeks after that, you get sick. About 10% of the people or so get sick and have to go in the hospital. Then once you're in the hospital, it takes weeks to get like worse, get in an ICU, and then if you survive. So it's the death rate is way behind the infection rate. That's why you're seeing the high deaths and the lower number of cases and low positivity. It's just part of the natural disease course.
But it is good news that the positivity rate is down to 2%, right?
Absolutely. This is a key marker, the positivity rate and the number of new cases.
Real quick, where are we on boosters for Moderna and Johnson & Johnson?
Yeah, so Moderna had some very encouraging data with their lower dose. So they're 100 microgram dose, and they have done tests with 50 micrograms. At first, the FDA put them off a little bit, and then they've looked closer at the data, and it looks, quote, encouraging, because that means that they can vaccinate, give boosters to twice as many people, and maybe the side effects will actually even be less. So that's really great. As far as Johnson & Johnson is concerned, their data that was released a little bit over a week ago show the boosters quite effective. So, you know, they're presenting all their data to the FDA, and there will be a recommendation for both Moderna and for Pfizer about the boosters in the coming weeks.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions. This person says, why is there such a difference in the Pfizer vaccine dose and the Moderna dose? 30 micrograms for Pfizer, 100 micrograms for Moderna. Is this why the efficacy of the Moderna vaccine is longer?
Well, this is a very logical question, but when they develop these, first of all, these are not the same vaccine. They're the same mechanism, but it's not the same. You've heard of like amoxicillin, and you've heard of penicillin, and you've heard, you know, other like penicillin-like drugs. It's the same thing with the vaccines. It's just the same kind of mechanism, but it's a different product. And when they did the early studies, they found that that was the most effective dose.
All right, next question. I am over the age of 65 and had my second Pfizer shot in March. Is there any benefit to waiting on the booster, or should I go now?
Definitely go now. The data that was presented just a couple weeks ago shows that the effect of that vaccine, the Pfizer vaccine, starts to decline after 4 months. Risk of hospitalization goes up 14%. So get it now. And you're going to need a booster for Moderna, too. So everyone's going to need a booster.
All right. This person says, how far apart should the flu vaccine and COVID vaccine boosters be given?
No, it doesn't have to be apart at all. Matter of fact, you can get them on the same day, different arm.
Oh, all right. Well, if you didn't get your question answered by Dr. Murphy, he answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or go to our Morning News Facebook page and post one there. We'll talk to Dr.